on missions. We carried a 45 pistol. There was a beautiful silk map of France. And then we had a survival pack, which was a little plastic case about maybe 6 by 6, an inch thick, sealed. And in it, there was a small blade, a hacksaw blade, about 3 inch long. It had something to put into water to sterilize water. Had a compass, a small compass, a fishing hook, and food for 3 or 4 days. And then part of it were these escape photos. We took them when we got to England. They put us in old clothing, made us look like we were Germans. And we carried those photos with us. In case we got shot down and got into the hands of the French forces of the interior, which was a group friendly to America and the British, they would take these photos and put them on passports so that we'd use those if necessary if we were stopped by German soldiers. Usually after 10 missions, we were awarded the Air Medal. And then for every 10 missions after that, you got one oak leaf cluster. I finally got the Air Medal with 6 oak leaf clusters because I had flown 69 missions. This is the Air Medal with 6 clusters, although I don't have the clusters shown. My pilot's wings, which I'm very proud of. And this is the Distinguished Flying Cross. I was the last of 12 or 13 airplanes on that mission. I was on the deck doing about 300 miles an hour, shooting into a hangar. Just as I pulled off, instead of pulling off to the left, which is an easy maneuver in an airplane that because of the torque pulling you that way, it's easier to turn left than it is to turn right. So I turned right because I was thinking that the German anti-aircraft would think I was going to turn left and I was going to fool them. I was making a very sharp climbing bank to get away. I got hit in the upper wing. When I say the upper wing, if I'm turning right, it's the wing on top. The P-47 had 50 caliber machine guns. The ammo trays in the wing were covered by a cover measured 2 feet by 6 feet. The hit that I got was on the lock that held that door. The door opened. It folded into the airstream, and it's like a one-door dive break, if you will. Within a half second, I was on my back. It just flipped me over like that. The underside of the wing had been torn off when the explosion occurred. I got it back over straight and level, and the gun door was lying on top of the wing, hitting the aileron. Ammo was trailing out all over the wing. I went out far enough that I could make a turn so that I could head west again. They were shooting at me all over the place, but I finally got away. I took it up to about 12,000 feet, slowed it down to about 120 miles an hour, put the wheels down. I didn't want to put the flaps down, didn't know what was going to happen, but the airplane was stable at that speed in those conditions, meaning that I could probably do a safe landing. Thank you. These are parts of a German anti-aircraft shell. The crew chief had given me two fragments that had lodged in the gun bay. For that flight, I got a DFC, Distinguished Flying Cross, 40 years later. After the war, nothing much was done about this kind of paperwork. Units were being broken up. People were too anxious to get home. The paperwork was written up for it by our intelligence officer who did all of this work for all the medals. Apparently, the paperwork got lost. But at one of our reunions, our intelligence officer was there. First thing he said when he saw me was, "Ty, did you ever get your DFC?" I says, "What DFC?" He says, "I think maybe I have a copy of the paperwork." And he gave me a carbon copy of the paperwork that had gone to the squadron commander. Apparently, going up the chain had never gone very far. My brother was in the Air Force back in Washington, D.C., and I wrote to him. I sent him a copy of the paperwork. I sent him a copy of my story. I sent him a copy of a picture that I had, and a year later, I was notified that I was given the DFC. There's a real wonderful ceremony out at the Air Force headquarters in El Segundo. A three-star general awarded me the DFC. There was a great big assembly, about 150 or 200 people in the assembly hall, mostly officers, and it was pretty wonderful. This is Ralph Hasbrook. I became buddies with him. We went to England as replacement pilots.
Into the air, Army Air Force, keep your nose up in the blue, up in the blue. And when you hear the engine singing and the steel drop starts to whine, you can bet the Army Air Force is along the firing line. Into the air.
Ralph Hasbrook, Freddie Buckner, and I, we went in as replacement pilots. Fred Buckner went down in the English Channel on his third mission and never heard anything from him. The mission that day was going over to England, stay overnight so that they could escort B-17s the next day into Germany. So it was on the trip over to England from France that he just disappeared. They went into real heavy fog over the English Channel, and he didn't come out the other side. I am quite sure it's vertical. If you're at 5,000 feet, you've got about 30, 40 seconds before you'll go in. You don't have time
to correct yourself.
Vertigo is losing all sense of where you are. Whether you're upside down, flying sideways, you have no sensation of what is correct. You don't know up or down. In flying formation, going into clouds, usually the lead pilot is doing all the instrument flying. The rest of the planes behind are close in and flying on that lead pilot. You're just watching his every motion, every movement of the airplane. If you lose that airplane and you don't have your own instruments set, why then you are going to get into vertigo very quickly. you need to be able to see the horizon or Earth in some way. And then you are able to correct yourself. I have six sisters, and they all became nuns. All were praying for me. All of the nuns in their organizations were praying. So there were a lot of prayers that brought me home. My brother also was in the Air Force, and when we both came home, you can imagine the relief of my parents and all of our family that we were both home, both safe. Now, did the guys that didn't get prayers come home? Sure they did. But I was lucky to have all those prayers helping me